Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Hello, 小朋友们，你们好，我是 Eric 姐姐。现在又到了我们赞美敬拜的时间，现在让我们一起开口来赞美我们的神。
如同草庐中的小草，蓝天中的小鸟，我整颗心被幸福围绕。哦，我慈爱的天父，认识你真好，你赐的福分别处找不着。你是我烦恼，喜乐充满在心头，忍受认识你真好，认识你真好，今生今世我不再寻找。哦，主啊，认识你真好，认识你真好，只愿分分秒秒在你慈爱的怀抱。如同草庐中的小草，蓝天中的小鸟，我整颗心被幸福围绕。哦，我慈爱的天父，认识你真好，你赐的福分别处找不着。你是我抛开一切烦恼，喜乐充满在心头，忍受认识你真好，认识你真好，今生今世我不再寻找。哦，主啊，认识你真好，认识你真好，只愿分分秒秒在你慈爱的怀抱。哦，主啊，认识你真好，认识你真好，今生今世我不再寻找。哦，主啊，认识你真好，认识你真好，只愿分分秒秒在你慈爱的怀抱。
小朋友又来到分享圣经故事时间。今天圣经故事是在创世纪第24章，为以撒娶妻。以撒已经长大成人，他的母亲撒拉已应年老去世，这时亚伯拉罕年纪也非常老迈，但他仍感到安慰，因为他记得神对以撒的应许，他会使以撒的后代成为大国。一天，他叫了伺候了他最久的仆人来，对他说：“该是替我的儿子娶妻的时候了。” 我不想他娶这迦南地四周任何一个女子为妻，你要往我本族本家的地方去，替他找个妻子，那是很远的地方。仆人说，或许那个女子不愿跟我走这么远回来呢，为什么不叫以撒返回美索不达米亚呢？不，亚伯拉罕坚决地说，神领我到这里来，允许把这地赐给我的后裔，以撒必须住在这里。但如果你所选的那个女子不愿跟你回来，那你也算是完成了差事。于是那个仆人带着十头骆驼踏上往美索不达米亚漫长的旅程。他到达亚伯拉罕的家族所住城外的一口井时，已是接近日落的时候了。他吩咐那些骆驼靠近井旁跪下，然后祷告说，我主人啊，亚伯拉罕的神啊，恳求你帮助我为以撒选择一个合适的女子做妻子。城内的女子快要出来井旁打水，我要问他们其中一人取水喝，哪一个愿意给我水喝，又乐意打水给那些骆驼喝的，我就知道是你所拣选给以撒做妻子的了。小朋友，这个故事让我们学习到几点功课。第一，亚伯拉罕对上帝的允许充满信心，知道上帝是位守约是慈爱的神。第二，亚伯拉罕有一位忠心尽职的老仆人。第三，老仆人也是位敬畏上帝的人，遇到困难会寻求上帝的帮助。亲爱的小朋友，让我们一起来祷告。主耶稣，谢谢你在这个圣经故事里让我们如何做个讨你喜爱的好孩子，学习爱你，做事忠心尽职，尊敬长辈。祷告奉主耶稣基督的名， Amen。
主恩典何等美好，你爱神也的宣告，过去现在和未来，主恩丰富奇妙。主的恩典大大小小，主的主恩典何等美好，比海深夜的山高，过去现在和未来，主恩丰富奇妙。主的恩典大大小小，主的恩典从头到脚，白白的来不能忘掉，感谢永驻永浪潮。啦啦啦啦啦，我要赞美，啦啦啦啦啦，我还要赞美，啦啦啦啦啦，我一生赞美，一生要来赞美主。主的恩典大大小小，主的恩典从头到脚，白白的 些永驻又浪潮，祝你恩典大大小小，祝你恩典从头到脚，白白的来不能忘掉，感谢永驻又浪潮。啦啦啦啦啦，我要赞美，啦啦啦啦啦，我还要赞美，啦啦啦啦啦，我一生赞美，一生要来赞美主，一生要来赞美主。
Hi children, happy blessed Sunday. Do you remember the Bible story that you heard about Abraham's son Isaac and how Abraham obeyed and feared God that he willingly sacrificed Isaac when God told him to do so? Now, the time has come and Isaac grows up to be an adult. It is time for Isaac to get married. Do you know what marriage is? It means to love and be together with the one person that God has prepared and chosen for us. I'm going to share to you about the story in Genesis chapter 24. Now, Abraham hoped that Isaac will marry a wife who believes and is faithful to God. He asked his servant to go to the home country and find a wife among his relatives for Isaac. Abraham also made sure his most trusted servant promises him that he will only find a wife for Isaac from the relatives and must not be any woman from the Canaanites, as they do not worship God. Abraham's servant did as he was told and loaded 10 camels with all kinds of gifts and set out to search for the wife for Isaac. The servant arrived somewhere near the well outside the town, around evening time. This is the time where women go out to draw water from the well. The servant prayed to God, "Lord, God of my master Abraham, make me successful today and show kindness to my master Abraham. See, I am standing beside this spring, and the daughters of the townspeople are coming out to draw water. May it be that when I say to a young woman, 'Please let me drink some water from your jar,' and she says, 'Drink, and I'll get some water for your camels too,' let her be the one you have chosen for your servant Isaac. By this, I will know that you have shown kindness to my master. Now, I have some discussions with you. The first, why Abraham did not want Canaanite woman to become Isaac's wife? It's because Canaanites did not believe in God, and he hoped Isaac to marry someone who's faithful to God. Now, the second discussion, how did the servant know which woman is the right wife that God prepared for Isaac? It is because he prayed to God and said that Whoever willingly give water to the camels are proof that God has chosen that woman for Isaac. Children, remember, praying to get guidance and answers from God is important so that we do not make the wrong choices or decisions that we will regret. Good job, children. Now, let's read these words with me before we conclude with a prayer. Proverbs chapter 16, verse 3. Commit to the Lord whatever you do, and your plans will succeed. Dear Lord, thank you for all that you have prepared and chosen for us in our life. We pray so that we will remember to pray for your guidance in everything that we do. We pray that our family and friends will be successful in all that they did. We pray that we will commit everything that we do to you. We will learn to pray every day and all the time for your peace and answers that will guide us through everything. We pray in the name of Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Today教小朋友如何自己DIY水果味yogurt 准备的材料有牛奶 Chelsea的麦片 yogurt 以及小孩子喜欢吃的水果首先准备5汤匙的yogurt 1小汤匙的pear seed 3汤匙的麦片 加入适量的牛奶 拿汤匙搅拌均匀 再将盖子盖回去 接下来放进冰箱里冷藏 切好的水果放进盘子里 打开冰箱 把冷藏好的yogurt拿出来 把切好的水果放进yogurt里 简单又好吃的水果 yogurt， 终于完成了。
Dear Father in Heaven, thank you for the night and the beautiful morning light, for rest and food and loving care, and all that makes the world so fair. Help us to do the things we should, to be to others kind and good. God bless me, my mommy and daddy, my brothers and sisters, my teachers and friends,and everyone around the world. Help us and teach us in all we do and all we say to grow more loving every day. Amen.